My name is Gary Wyatt, Extension Educator with the University of Minnesota Extension. And today we're going to talk about winter control of buckthorn and other woody invasives and other woody species that you want to control in your environment and landscapes. First of all, you want to identify the trees and shrubs that you want to control. Wintertime is a great control opportunity for controlling buckthorn with the proper herbicide. Certainly identify buckthorn by the points or thorns at the very tips of the branches. Not every branch will have a thorn, but most of them will. Most of the other species will have a bud at the very tip of the branch. Also, you can cut the stem, and it will show an orange or yellowish type tint to the sapwood. That's another identifying factor of buckthorn. After you've identified that, and actually, you may want to look at a perimeter type roping of a tape or rope, maybe a 20 by 20, 30 by 30 area. So you're not just walking in your woodland and just trying to treat everything that's not roped off. Do a roped off area first and then treat that first and then go on to the other areas of your woodland. So here we have a tape in the background. Also, buckthorn has male and female trees. Here is a female cutting of a buckthorn stem. And obviously they have berries still into December. Obviously very prone, they're very prolific seed bearer these plants are, and they still can be carried by birds and eaten by birds and spread that way. So certainly target your female trees of buckthorn first. Also, the best treatment is a stump cut treatment. You want to cut the stump first and then treat the outer rim of the bark. And you don't need to treat the heartwood, but you need to treat the outer rim of the bark with a proper herbicide. And usually use a brush killer that has triclopyr in it. It's a great herbicide and a good woodland herbicide that controls woodies. So triclopyr is a great active ingredient to look for in a brush killer. You can use different applicators. Here's an applicator here that you can put the product in. Also, another applicator method would be just simply a jar and a type of brush or foam brush with the proper labeled herbicide in it in the container. Always read and follow label directions. Also, we have excellent information on our website, My Minnesota Woods, and also the University of Minnesota Extension, and that's www.extension.umn.edu.